Hello, I am Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com, and today we will talk about development of chorionic villi during third week of development. So as we have discussed that at the end of second week of development, the embryo consists of two germ layers, the epiblast and hypoblast layer, and this two germ layered embryo is converted to trilamina, the three germ layered embryo during third week of development. Along with that, it consists of two balloon-like structures. One is the amniotic cavity and the other one is yolk sac. Whole this structure, this embryo proper, along with its two personal balloons, is floating inside the chorionic cavity. It is also called extraembryonic cavity. So this whole this structure is floating in the chorionic cavity, except it is attached at this point that is called connecting stalk. And this membrane, this structure is called chorion, and it consists of two layers. The inner layer, this is the inner layer, which is extraembryonic somatopleuric mesoderm, and the outer layer, this outer layer, it consists of cytotrophoblast. And of course, outside this cytotrophoblast is the syncytiotrophoblast. And you may be remembering from the lecture of second week of development that there are lacunae present, a lacunar network is present within the syncytiotrophoblast, and maternal blood flows through this lacunar network. Now, as we have discussed already, that during the second week, at the end of second week of development, the finger-like projections arise from the cytotrophoblast. These are those finger-like projections, finger-like processes that arise from this cytotrophoblast, and we call it primary villi. Now, in today's lecture, we will discuss that what happens to these villi, that what stages of development these villi undergo. These are also called chorionic villi. So let's enlarge a single primary villi and let's first see its structure, and then we will see what happens to that primary villi in subsequent stages of development. So here is a single primary villi, and as you can see that it is a solid cord. Here in this 3D diagram you can see that it is a solid cord made up of these cytotrophoblastic cells. So this is basically a cut section. Let's say we have cut here and we are looking at the top in this 3D diagram. So here is that cut section, and here you can see that this primary villi, it is a solid cord of cytotrophoblastic cells. Early on, most of the primary villi are unbranched, but later on some of the primary villi, they become branched. So these branched primary villi, they are also similar in structure to the unbranched primary villi. The only difference is that there is this kind of branching pattern, and we call it branched primary villi. So after the formation of primary villi during third week of development, what happens to this primary villi? So what happened here is that this inner cell of this primary villi, these inner cell, they degenerated, and here was the extraembryonic somatopleuric mesoderm. So what happens that as the inner cell degenerated, inner cytotrophoblastic cells of this primary villi degenerated, the extraembryonic mesoderm, it proliferated, this mesenchyme, it proliferated and it went inside the core of this villus. Now at this stage, these primary villi, they are now called secondary villi. Well, villi is simply the plural term and villus is the singular term, so don't get confused by this terminology. So this is the secondary villi. So what is difference between primary and secondary villi? Primary villi is the solid cord of cytotrophoblastic cells, but the secondary villi, it has an inner core of extraembryonic mesoderm. So here in this 3D diagram you can see that it has an outer periphery of cytotrophoblast. This is the secondary villi. It has an outer periphery of cytotrophoblast, and inside is the mesenchymal core that is made up of extension of this extraembryonic mesoderm into this villus. So this is the secondary villi. Then what happens to this secondary villi is that the mesenchyme of this extraembryonic mesoderm leads to formation of blood vasculature inside the villus. So as the blood vessels are formed inside this villus, now it is called tertiary villus. Now these types of villi in which the blood vessels are present, they are called tertiary villi. This capillary network of tertiary villus, it consists of an efferent end. Here is the efferent ends that brings the less oxygenated and nutrient deficient blood to this villi. And then there is that efferent end that takes back the oxygenated and nutritious blood back to the embryo. This efferent end is also called arterial end, and the efferent end is also called the venous end. In adults, the veins contain deoxygenated blood and arteries contains oxygenated blood, but here the situation is opposite. So here in this 3D diagram, you can also see the tertiary villus, which has an arterial or efferent end that contains less oxygenated blood and efferent or venous end that contains highly oxygenated blood. So this is the vascular network of this villus embedded inside the extraembryonic mesodermal extension, and outside both of these structure is the cytotrophoblastic cells in the periphery. And of course outside this would be the syncytiotrophoblast, which is not shown in this diagram. So in the last diagram we had seen the unbranched tertiary villus, but actually at this stage most of the villi, they are branched. Now how these tertiary villi work, what is their function, what is their significance? We will see the details in the lecture of placenta, but here let's have a brief overview of the things that we will study in later lectures. So here is a single branch tertiary villus, and here is its neighboring branched tertiary villus. I'm just gonna call it tertiary villus. Of course outside this is the syncytiotrophoblast that contains these spaces or lacunae. And the structure, this embryo, it is embedded into the maternal endometrium. As the embryo buries inside the maternal endometrium, we have seen already that it erodes the maternal tissue. And here you can see that, let's suppose it has eroded a maternal blood vessel. As it does so, the maternal blood starts flowing into this lacunar spaces. As these lacunar spaces become enlarged, later on we will see that they are then named as intervillous spaces because they become so large that they almost completely form this space between the two neighboring villi. At this stage they are called lacunae, but later they will form the intervillous spaces. So what happens here is that blood started flowing, the maternal blood started flowing into lacunae. Meanwhile, what happened here is that the cytotrophoblast from this villus branch as well as this villus branch, it proliferated and it formed a layer or shell here, which we call as outer trophoblastic shell. It penetrated through the syncytiotrophoblast to form this outer trophoblastic shell. Here you can see that especially this branch of tertiary villus, it is helping in anchoring this structure, this future placenta, to the maternal tissue. So this villus, this branch of villus is called anchoring branch of villus, or simply anchoring villus. It is also called stem villus. So this is the stem villus or anchoring villus. Along with that, what happens that, as we have discussed, that blood starts flowing into these lacunae. So these villi, these free villi here, they will take up the nutrients and oxygen from this lacunar blood, and they will take up this nutrients and oxygen and bring it into this blood. So in this way they absorb the nutrients, they help in absorption of nutrients, so they are also called absorbing villus. So we have two types of villi. Some are helping to anchor the placenta, they are called anchoring villi. The other one, they helps in absorbing the nutrition and they are called absorbing villi. Please note that later on there will be some changes in this apparatus such that it will become much more robust and efficient in absorbing the nutrients from the maternal blood. At that time we will call this apparatus as placenta, and we will discuss the details of placenta in later lectures. So let's have a review of what we have read. So primary villi, which is a solid cord of cytotrophoblast, the secondary villi, which consist of extension of mesenchyme from extraembryonic mesoderm, and final stage is the formation of vasculature inside this mesenchymal extension from extraembryonic mesoderm. So three type of villi are formed. At the end of second week we have primary villi, then subsequently in third week the development is up to the tertiary villi. And finally, here are these branching villi that consist of anchoring villi as well as the absorbing villi. Thank you so much for watching this video.